As mid lane, they've gone in now, trying to focus on S4, who dove really far. But Crypt Swarm will find him. Now they chase in with G, having a haste rune. Could well be your first blood, juking in the trees, perhaps. One more auto attack secures the kill. The final Crypt Swarm
is on his way to ball out of control.
Oh, they're setting up G. not anymore.
Right, I said that.
You jinxed him, Ben. They'll jump in mid. They had the chance to start. Jotun arrives. He'll grave and heal. Did he grave a bit too early? Secret continue to chase him out. It looks like it's the right time. They don't want to risk it. Then the Ogre comes in. The stun. The follow-up nukes. The ult finds the trade. 2-0 for VP. These are heroes that can really take advantage. And
Kuro.
Now the Ogre bottom. Kuro, this could be trouble for him. Sadoi lurching forward. They're going for it now. Kuro's trapped out. There's your stun. The orb to follow. Yol. He keeps on coming up flush.
He's killing top.
Both teams making their moves right now. BZZ starts dealing S4's damage. He won't have the follow-up to get this kill. There's a grave waiting. It'll be used now. But Simba comes in. Ravage is ready. Lets it fly. Hits on three. Sadoi couldn't get off the silence in time. The Fissure secures that first kill. Then the Coil looks for the trade. Fly will end up dropping. It looks like G rotating with Exorcism at the ready. Kuro joins the fight as well. Big commitment from Secret and a big win for them. Now they'll corner Sadoi and look to bring him down. Looking to make the 2-for-3 exchange. He tries to orb out. Can he escape? He gets healed up. Then the Remnant Bomb from S4, still surviving there this time, gets off the chains. That'll end him now. It makes it a pretty much anyone who's caught by this will die. G would be one of the worst heroes to drop, and he gets caught by a chain at the start. And now the arrow follow-up. Calldown was used. They really want this G kill. They'll get it to the most farm here on VP. Again, plummeting. Don't see any defense in sight from Secret yet. Kuro's hiding in the trees, though. Looks like they want to contest it. Ravage is also ready. They're bringing an S4 from the side. Exorcism will still go for a bit longer. They clear out the creep wave, but they don't have any creeps of their own to tank. Do they risk it with the Death Prophet? G inching closer. And S4, he's ready to jump in now. We're going to have a little clash here. BZZ caught out with the quick multicast on S4. Trying to buy them time. Ravage really doesn't get anything accomplished. BZZ now grave from the high ground. Kept alive for ages. The turn will probably come now. A remnant in again from S4. Just in case he goes down. Another multicast searching. It's a Tidehunter for Razor with a Ravage expended. They did not get the tower yet, though. And now S4 is on the chase. Surging forward onto Jotun. We'll find him. Chains pulling down. Arrow connects. That's a kill. Confirmed on the Jotun, he can heal and try and live, but S4 is looking for the next kill. Finds the Ogre Magi at his own tier 1. No multi-guess this time. Immediate TP out attempted. No Fissure. No Arrow. Jotun's going to have to play his positioning perfectly.
Here we go. Is there a Blink Dagger on Fly? Yes, there is.
They have a Glyph. They're going to use it now as well.
This is going to catch them completely off guard, too. They're in a good position to defend again, defend G, but that's...
And S4's invis.
Pending they walk up.
Tower's already down, and they come in. Ravage connects, this time on three. The heal's there from Jotun. Didn't get caught in the Fissure, actually blocking them away. And now the turn comes. They go right back in on S4, looking for Fly as well. They already lost Kuro as the fight began, and now S4 turns with the chains. Silence was timed, but not quite right. Still, they get the stun, and S4 will drop two. Two cores down. Your Murano limping back towards the well. Arrow.
Yeah, or try and trade. But their lineup is geared toward defending tower, so VP don't necessarily want to fall in that trap, but at the same time, they don't... Oh, Sadoi.
He's played this one so well, but he will end up getting punished. Multicast on the Kuro. Now Arrow straight down the river. Ogre too big to dodge that one. This should be a 2-for-0. Will he have the quick reactions to dodge these? Another Arrow. It's on Sadoi mid. Now they go in with their missile follow-up and the Ravage, but it's dodged by Faceship G. Can he get off the Yule Scepter in the nick of time? Now the nukes coming out from the Ogre, trying to finish somebody off. They've got a Dazzle in reserve. G will pop his ult. BKBs were used here. Kurogi trying to retreat. Another Sleight of Fist and a Blink. A Silence. A Coil that caught three. Kurogi will break it, just trying to run the hell away. They can't fight against this. Too much damage from VP. Three heroes fall. Sadoi bailing them out, and he's looking to make it four. Simba on the run. There's a Silence not even needed. The orb does it. Had a few seconds to go on that silence. VP.
Static Link.
This could be so big for VP. BZZ lurches forward. He's got his BKB ready. They're going to hex Simba to start. He will have a Ravage. He's four-stepped out. He's too low to fight now. Exorcism was also used. They only lose the Tidehunter. That's the biggest loss.
That's really good for Secret.
And they're going to go for it. Exorcism now popped. Aegis about to wear off. Range Rax will fall. Do they try to commit fully for the melee here? They're attempting to do it as safely as possible. Well, Puppy looks, but the Ravage comes through. A good one. Caught four. Is it enough, though? BKB now used by G. Exorcism still going strong during this time. BZZ face tanking everything. Charging onto the gyrocopter. Kuro just can't stand against it. He'll end up falling. He's got to buy back immediately. And now the Echo Slam for Big Daddy. Can they find that turn? Flag Cannon's not ready for 15. Exorcism now ends. The arrow hits Yol. It might be too much damage now. With no Exorcism, no Razor, I don't think they can stand and fight any longer. Gyro and Ember can just run them down. They try for the chains. They won't get them, but they get the kill anyway from auto attacks. And now the chase is on. Jotam on the retreat out. S4 with the sleight of fist chains. Boy down momentarily. He gets it too. First bounce right onto him. Grave, TP out. Is it going to happen? Nope. Not going to happen. They lose their gem as well. Triple kill for Kuro. VP might have some Yule Scepters and some BKBs, but they don't have too many. BZZ, duke it out with Kuro. If he dies here, it would be a dieback. He hasn't used his ultimate yet, though. Still holding Eye of the Storm. Now he's going to commit it. S4 will fall to this. That's an Ember out of the fight. Do they get the Kuro kill? That's the big one. No teleport. Coil's there. They try to keep him alive. Secondary Ravage. Is this going to be good enough from Simba? On to three. On to four. He caught. BZZ brings down Kuro. It's a dieback for him. But everyone else falling. G, no exorcism for 15. VP just didn't have enough left in the tank, and now they chase onwards. They buy back on the Razor. Like, with the advantage they had, you'd think they would have easily taken it. Do they even Exorcism for this? There is a glyph. They have their Razor ult. They're going to try and hold Exorcism. Maybe they go for a Tier 2 push bottom next.
They could go for Throne. It's either Throne or Spec Off.
There's no Ravages. Throne might not be the worst idea, honestly, but there's an Echo Slam for Big Daddy. Who needs Tidehunter? We've got Earthshaker. Is it actually sufficient, though? S4 now silenced. Chased out by G. They get their multicast on Fly. He's down for 70. Doesn't have Ravages for longer than that regardless. And they go for the top lane. Actually looking for Puppy. They're still a Tier 2 here. They can't take a second later back. Again, Big Daddy! He keeps on delivering with these initiations. Awesome jumps from the Earthshaker. They'll get 4 as the trade. It's probably G going down here too. Exorcism wearing off. Everybody from Secret straight onto him. Sure, they're using buybacks, but they're getting big kills. G completely surrounded. Kenny retreat out. Yule Scepter at the ready. He'll try for the teleport. That ain't gonna happen. Big Daddy with the big saves. They have 5 buybacks now. Most of them can rejoin the fights, and they go in mid. 2 hero Fisher to start. Now the Ravage. No hesitation from Fly. Secondary Ravage is incoming. Got off the Anchor Smash, and they burst G low. He does get off the grave. Now Sidoy blinks in. G has a BKB. He's gonna pop it right away. Just runs for the hills. That leaves Sidoy in no man's land. The gem hits the deck. They're gonna lose Sidoy as well. Bit of miscommunication here from VP going in with the puck, losing BZZ as well, crumbling under the pressure, and Secret lump just charge forward for Jotam. They don't actually commit too much, trying to flak off this tower to kill him off. Kuro won't actually get the flak bounces needed. Now they turn. They've got the Razor ultimate. Exorcism going as well during this time, but Kuro stands and tanks through it as best he can. They begin to zap him repeatedly. His armor is dropping fast. A nice vision from Big Daddy. Staggering the retreat here for Secret. No more Ravages, but confidence from their carries on to BZZ. Again, the Graves from Jotam, keeping them alive. As he continues to march forward, BZZ will pop his cheese. Will try and finish off S4, who zips to the left, then to the right. Completely confusing them, and while that's happening, curls into through the bottom. He's trying to take a first lane of Rax here. It will be secured, it looks like. No, boots will travel out immediately. Can they cancel this? Can they cancel it? Not gonna happen. Nobody can come in, and while they're busy rotating bottom, it's G who falls mid, most likely. One more slice from the Tidehunter. Secret, finding the openings here late game. That Razor doesn't have buyback. The Death Prophet might have to use it, dead for 90 seconds. Buyback status on Secret, they have everything. Great win for them.
It's all set up by Big Daddy again, setting those two, putting them in a position to get hit by Ravage without a chance to BKB, and commend Earthshaker, please.
Yeah. It's just the range of Fissure at No-Tail playing it so incredibly well. He finds another Fissure onto BZZ. Again, there's no Ravages. I don't know if they fully go for this, but they can definitely chip away at him. Ogre looking for those legendary multicasts, not really getting too many when he desperately needs them. They silence S4 and they charge it onto him, beginning to steal his damage, but Kuro stands strong. He zones them back for now. Exorcism was used. This was the refresher exorcism. Won't have one for a long time. They already lost the Mirana. They are focusing Big Daddy. He's used all his stuns just to slow down BZZ. S4 taking too much damage from the ghost will end up dropping. They've lost one. They may lose more. Kuro fights it out, wins the man fight, turns for more. The buyback from S4 straight back in. This might be GG. No Razor buyback at this point. He already used it. That's a dieback for him. Death Prophet, no exorcisms. They basically got nothing, Ben. Just a bunch of limp bodies that can't offer.
And they still have Ravage. One more Ravage and it could be game.
Could be 2 Ravages. Only 30 seconds on that. Maybe just 1. This looks to be the... Oh, we don't want to fight recap now. We want a Throne if we're Secret. Pushing through the mid. They'll take 2 lanes of Rax. They look for the Megas. They use Leap to get a little bonus attack speed. And this Rax will begin falling. It's Mega Creeps for Team Secret. It looked like a rough start for them. VP had them where they wanted them early, but they just couldn't keep them down. Too much good movement from Secret. too many good fights. They hang on here, and with Megas, and still with a buyback on their core gyrocopter, it will be tough for VP to turn this one around. Nearly impossible. They force out a BKB on G. Oh, he missile will come in. It's going to dink him as he goes back to the well. He will survive there, but this gives time for Secret now. Looking at their current gold, they've got plenty. 8k gold up on Kuro. Still has the power tread, so he's basically 7 slotted if he wants it. And they just right-click down the towers. Tier 4 about to drop. Secret looking for their opening win here in Group B action. They'll be atop the standings after this one. It is only the first match. And they close in now. Another fissure. This one onto G. And commitment. Four step. Ravage on the way. And it's a drive-by from Simba. Second one caught more. Yolf as well as Jotam. Sadoi 2. GG. Secret bounce back and take a very convincing win here in the end.
That was scary for them. The protected Death Prophet just was the bane of their existence. Oh my goodness.
Big Daddy MVP.
Yeah, Big Daddy bailed them out of that
one. So hard. Oof. If he doesn't win them that fight mid, they lose the game. Or they definitely lose lane of Raxadev, like the steepest hill ever to climb back up. Well, in the end, Team Secret.
Man, VP looked crazy.